Hello, my name is Faisal Jahangiri. I'm Vice President of Clinical Affairs at Access Neuromonitoring, and I'm going to teach you the workshop today. The title of the first workshop we are going to do is Measurement of the Head According to International 1020 System. So head measurement is one of the key and very important factor that is going to affect your signals in the operating room. So what we like to do is to go to the preoperative area, talk to the patient, and measure the head and mark the point we are going to use for placing the electrode. So in order to go to the to do that, just make sure you have two important things in your pocket. One is flexible measuring tape and a marker. You can use any color of marker of your choice. So measuring of the head, why it's important to measure the head is because you can place the electrode any place on the head, and if you are doing a sensory evoked potential, you get some type of response. It may not be the accurate response or the response you're looking for. It may be an inverted response. It may be a small amplitude response. It may be a deflected response, but some kind of response. But if you don't know the electrode is placed on the right place or wrong place, you will not be able to interpret the data correctly. For motor evoked potential, if your electrode placement is wrong, so you have to stimulate very high. And when you stimulate very high, because you are farther from the motor area and you're stimulating at a higher voltage to get a response. But if you stimulate at a higher voltage, what will happen is the patient is going to move a lot, and at the end, the surgeon is going to tell you not to stimulate while he's operating, because that patient movement is bothering him or is causing interruption in the surgical field. So if you measure the head and place the electrode for the motor evoked potential and sensory evoked potential at the right spot, you can activate the motor cortex and get the response at a lower threshold with the least amount of patient movement and as frequent as possible. So the first step we do is going to measure from nasion to anion. So from nasion, you place the measuring tape at the nasion and measure the distance from nasion to anion. If the distance is, for example, 40 centimeter and have to be in centimeter, we don't measure in the centimeter inches, so it has to be in centimeter. So if the distance is 40 centimeter, you measure the half of that. So the 50% point is CZ point, which is 20 centimeters. So the half of 40 centimeter is 20 centimeter, so that's the CZ point. But that CZ can be tilted toward the left side or right side, depending how you're placing your electrode, your tape. So in order to, the next step is to measure the distance from A1 to A2, which is the left, in front of the left ear to the right ear, and measure the middle point of that. So the half of that, and we cross that half with the CZ. This point is your true CZ prime, and that we mark the CZ prime. So whatever distance you have, if you have another 40 centimeter, for example, we go, that's a 50% 20 centimeter, and then we measure. The next step is to measure the 20% point on the right side and to the left side. So the 20% of 40 centimeter, and it has to be 20 centimeter of the whole distance from A1 to A2, not the 20% of half of that. So the 20% of 40 centimeter is 8 centimeter. So we measure from CZ prime to the right side, 8 centimeter, and mark that point as C4. And we measure 20% on the left side, which is C3, and mark that. So those are your C3, CZ, and C4 points. And these are the points we have from C3 and C4, you can place the electrode or mark the place to place for motor evoked potential. For sensory evoked potential, you measure 2 centimeter posterior to that. So 2 centimeter posterior to C3, and then 2 centimeter posterior to C4, and 2 centimeter posterior to CZ. So those are CP3, CP4, and CPZ point. So these points, these three points you're going to mark to place the electrode in the OR when the patient is intubated for sensory evoked potential recording. The last point we need to do and to measure is FPZ. So FPZ, you can do 40% anterior to CZ, or you can do 20% posterior to nasion. So that's how we are going to do the measurement of head today.